Hi there, it's Kaylee. Today, we're going to use a number line to determine if inequalities with negative numbers and variables are true or false. Let's go. Now let's take a look at the points on this number line. Based on the number line, which of these statements are true? The first statement says points x, y, and z are all negative numbers. And that would mean x, y, and z are all less than zero. Are these statements true? Well, let's find out. X is equal to negative 5, so this is the same as negative 5 less than zero. Is that statement true? Yes. The next one says y is less than zero. And y is equal to 0. So this statement says 0 is less than 0. Is that statement true? No. 0 is equal to 0. This next one says z is less than 0. Is that true? If we have negative 2 less than 0, is that a true inequality? Yes. But if we have two true inequalities and one inequality that's not true, that means our statement is false. Let's try the next statement. It says point Y is greater than point Z and X. Is this true? This would mean that Y is greater than Z and Y is greater than X. If Y is 0, this inequality would say 0 is greater than z, which is negative 2. And y, this inequality here, 0 is greater than x, which is negative 5. Are these inequalities true? Yes, 0 is greater than any negative number. So that means this statement is true. Let's try that last one. Point X is greater than point Z and Y. So this is saying X is greater than Z and X is greater than Y. Are these true? If X here is equal to negative 5, greater than Z, which is negative 2, and this one here, X is equal to negative 5, greater than Y is equal to 0. Are these inequalities true? Negative 5 is less than negative 2, so that's not true. And is negative 5 greater than 0? No way. We know that 0 is greater than any negative number. So it looks like this statement is also false. Gabe is going ice climbing. His pants and jacket will keep him warm down to negative 8 degrees. But ice climbing is only safe if the temperatures stay less than 0 degrees. On which days will it be safe for Gabe to ice climb and not too cold for his clothing? Okay, let's start by calling the temperature T. And as it says here, his pants and jacket will keep him warm down to negative 8 degrees. That means if T is less than negative 8, Gabe's gonna be cold. So which of these temperatures is T greater than negative 8? Let's check our inequalities. On Friday, T is equal to 4. Is 4 greater than negative 8? Yep, that one checks out. How about on Saturday? Is negative 9 degrees greater than negative 8 degrees? No. Negative 9 is smaller than negative 8. How about on Sunday? Is negative 2 degrees greater than negative 8 degrees? Yeah, it is. So on Saturday, Gabe will be too cold in his clothes to go ice climbing. But we have another requirement here. Ice climbing is only safe if the temperatures stay less than 0 degrees. So that is telling me that when T is greater than 0, danger. So that means we need T to be less than 0 degrees. Let's check our weather forecast here. Is 4 degrees less than 0 degrees? No, obviously not. How about here? Is negative 9 degrees less than 0 degrees? Yep, that checks out. Negative numbers are less than 0. How about on Sunday? Is negative 2 less than 0 degrees? Yes, by our same logic, negative numbers are less than 0. Okay, so on what day do both of our requirements check out? It's warm enough that Gabe won't be cold in his clothes, but cold enough that it's safe to ice climb. Yeah, on Sunday, right? Sunday is the only day that the temperature is greater than negative 8, but less than 0. So this is the day that Gabe can go on his ice climbing trip. Whew, that was some complex math thinking. You did great. We have another video about negative numbers and how the negative symbol can be used to mean opposite. It's called Negative Numbers, Opposites on the Number Line. I'll see you there. Hey, hey.